Good morning.
Good morning.
This is our mission moment. up to date, we have partnered with 29 states to bring the gospel to our nation. And does anyone recall what our target is? How much money are we wanting to collect? $2,500, that's correct. And so far we have collected $1,445 and a few cents. So we have two more weeks to make that collection. And you can see the blank states, including Alaska, down here, that we need to cover. And every $50, then we color a state. And if you have a favorite state that you want to color, when you put your donation in, why don't you just name that? But I think so many of the people here are from Texas. Already, we should have made that one more than $50. Amen. But it is so big. Okay, that's about it. And I noticed, I saw people writing checks this morning, so I know we're going to get more money. Thank you.
Cincinnati. Jensine Ashley was born here, raised here, and broken here.
My mom got really depressed when I was really sick. And at the time my mom died, I was the only one really living here.
In 2010, Jensine was a college student with a broken life and a falling apart house.
Everyone's gone, and I'm grieving, and I have this whole house to take care of.
That's when a mutual friend told Jensine about Josh Lemon. Josh is a North American missionary who had been talking with his neighbors about starting a church.
We got to throw together a crew and do a little roofing or a little painting. And so we, one Saturday, we descended. And this is just a picture of what he does to brokenness. And fixes things.
Like I say, like they saved me, like not them saved me, but through God.
And may you find yourself crying out in the depths for your Father who loves to rescue.
In many ways, the church plant called Red Door was born that day. Now Josh, Jensine, and 100 other people in Cincinnati know what a Red Door means.
The meaning of it is it's a place of welcome, a place of refuge. I think that there's something exciting about church planting. And I think the reason for that is it's about restoring people.
Am I on?
You're on.
Okay, thank you. We want to take a moment to our whatever it takes to introduce a brand new person to some of you. Some of you know. Melanie Isabel. And the parents are right here. They're going to come down and you'll get a chance to see this beautiful baby. We've all been very interested in this whole drama. and the baby's here and doing well, and we're happy with you, both of you, about that. What we'd like to do is to encourage the parents to dedicate themselves and their lives to the Lord and to His church, and declare that you will do your best to rear this child in the admonition of the Lord. We understand, all right? And I think this is a wonderful thing that parents are willing to say, as best we can, we're going to dedicate our child to the Lord through us, because we're planning to see to it that the education and the testimony of the Lord is always present in the home. congratulations on the birth of a child. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you so much. God bless you. I should say that may their tribe increase. God bless you for being here. Thank you.
Okay, besides the new baby and the parents there, we know we have visitors. That's wonderful. Is there any other visitors this morning, first time, White Avenue Baptist Church? We'd like to greet you. Anybody at all? I see some finger pointing going on. Nephew Cameron.
Years ago.
We got a South Carolina in the office. All right. Well, hey, on that note, let's all stand and greet our visitors and just give everybody a warm White Avenue welcome. Jesus. Now, remember, our glorious Easter Sunday is coming up. we're just building up our music program in anticipation of that celebration day. We're going to have our Easter choir up here, which again, remember, resumes tonight at 6 o'clock. Got it. Okay. We're going to practice again for this program. We always sing about songs of the cross, but this time of the year is one of the times that the world even pauses to recognize the birth and the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, which is what? A golden opportunity to witness. So we're magnifying the blood, we're magnifying the cross, and we're singing about that. Do you have a good friend in Jesus? He's a friend that's sticking closer than a brother. Amen. Let's sing this wonderful hymn. What a friend.
All our sins. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you very much for your blessings to this church. We pray you will continue to bless this church individually and correctly. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your unconditional love. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. Lord, you are our strength. We shall be strong. Lord, you are our light. We shall not worry about darkness. Lord, you are our shepherd. We shall not want. Lord, we thank you for your merciful kindness. Lord, we thank you for your loving kindness. Lord, we have hope in you. Lord, we have love in you. Lord, we have strength in you. Lord, we trust you always, no matter what. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Yeah. This morning before I sing, I want to relate the scripture verse that has to do with the song. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 7, that in the ages to come, God might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us through Christ Jesus.
What God is